When teachers grade student work, they match the qualities in student responses to the standards descriptors in order to make on-balance judgments. Each dimension is made up of a number of different objectives, so teachers work their way through each objective, making them match to the standards to decide whether they best correspond to the A, B, C, D, or E descriptors. Once they have completed this process, they may have a number of ticks or annotations on their criteria sheet, which could inform an on-balance judgment. The syllabus standards describe work of a typical standard, but not all students will perform at a typical standard. Therefore, in order to record their fine-grained decision-making about student achievement, teachers may choose to use pluses and minuses. Let's take one particular student response. For the first dimension, the qualities in the work might typically match B standard descriptors. In a second dimension, sometimes the work may have some, for example, C qualities, but on balance, the best match may be to the B standard. So a teacher may put a B minus on that work to indicate that there are some C qualities, but not so many that it would be judged as a C. Similarly, a B plus might be awarded to a dimension which has some qualities that match to the A standard, but not so many as to be judged an A on balance. Teachers might use a profile sheet to record their achievement decisions. The profile sheet is simply a recording device for teachers. It is not used to make a decision. It simply records decisions that a teacher has made throughout the assessment program. Syllabuses do not make reference to pluses and minuses. Teachers may wish to use pluses and minuses to help them express fine-grained achievement decisions. Some schools might choose to use pluses and minuses. Others may not. However, schools are required to use the syllabus standards to make judgments about student achievement.